In this video, I am going to explain important anatomical relationship of nervous tissue and pain. This bundle is brachial plexus. Brachial plexus. Brachial plexus is bundle of nerve. These nerves go to shoulder, chest, arm, elbow, wrist, fingers. That's why brachial plexus is very important for upper extremity. When brachial plexus got damaged or impingement, that can create pain or numbness for upper extremity. Okay, this is freaking important. Now, I want to talk about three muscles that have relationship with brachial plexus. This is scalene. This is scalene. Scalene. This one is subclavius. Subclavius. It is below clavicle. And this one is pectoralis minor. Let's say pec minor. These three muscles have relationship with brachial plexus. Think about scalene. Brachial plexus emerge in between scalene. This place. Let's see. Subclavius. Brachial plexus has relationship with subclavius. Okay? And brachial plexus passes posterior to pec minor. So, when all of these muscles or one of them gets tight, that can create impingement for brachial plexus. Does it make sense? Impingement can happen here or here or here. These three places are very important for brachial plexus. When brachial plexus got impingement at either place, that can be cause for thoracic outlet syndrome. Okay? Thoracic outlet syndrome. Okay? Pain around here. However, wait a minute. This is kind of a resting position of shoulder. You know, your arm is hanging down. What happens when you move shoulder? Let's check relationship. Okay, this is arm abducted position. It's like 100 degrees or 110 degrees. Let's say 110 degree. Now, let's imagine there is pectoralis minor like this, scalene like this, subclavius like this. And how does brachial plexus run at 110 degrees shoulder abduction? It may run like this. You know, it should be going like this. Let's compare with another picture. This is first picture. It's going like this. See that? This is resting position of shoulder. Now, this is 110 degrees abduction. See, brachial plexus must run like this because of this arm position. Now, what happens when pectoralis minor or subclavius or scalene gets tight? Let's say there is impingement here. Now, that can create maybe friction or impingement here. Now, there's more stress on brachial plexus. Why? Because even in normal abducted position, nerve should be bent like this. Plus, what if these muscles get tight? That can create even more stress for brachial plexus. That's why when people have thoracic outlet syndrome and when they move shoulder, they can have pain because of this relationship. Again, this is normal position. Brachial plexus is running like this. even in normal position when pec minor or subgravius or scaling gets tight, that can create impingement even under normal condition. Let's say this is abducted position. Brachial plexus runs like this. Even in normal condition, nerve gets more stress when you raise up arm, okay? Plus, what happens when these muscles get tight? That can put more stress for brachial plexus. That is why relationship among these muscles and brachial plexus is freaking important. In this video, I explained relationship among muscles and brachial plexus. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.